Hey everybody, it's Jason from Jason's Dog Walking Training. Here walking my buddy Coda here. He's sporting his new harness, rocking the blue. My buddy. And you know he's sniffing all the snow here because he's a dog. Why wouldn't he do that? But I'm making this video today because I want to talk a little bit about what's on my mind. And I was debating on what exactly I should talk about. I have a lot of ideas that run through my head all the damn time. And I want to try sharing them. If you've seen any of my other videos, you know I'm trying to do this. I'm just trying to get some information out there, help everybody. And Coda here is helping me today. Hey, Coda. No, he's not. He's actually just sniffing everything and ignoring me. But he's enjoying it. He's enjoying it. But today I think I'm going to talk about a little bit about sort of philosophy, ideas, beliefs, and how it can affect our dogs. So, I've worked with a couple of clients, and something I realized is that a lot of people don't really want to admit that they're wrong. And that's okay. I hate to be told that I'm wrong. I hate being wrong in general. Like, I'm basically perfect. Like, how can you tell me I'm wrong? I mean, really, nothing that ever comes out of my mouth is wrong, except that it is. And I can be wrong about almost anything that I think I know, whatever it may be. And I understand the feeling of, you know, not wanting to give up a belief and not wanting to change your actions. And I mean, you have to admit you're wrong in order to change what you're doing. And that's hard. That's hard for everybody. It's hard for me. And I understand it. Again, sorry if any of the wind is sort of messing with the audio. I just record these right off my iPhone. It's not like I have any special equipment. So if you hear any interference, I apologize. But back to what I was saying, it's really hard to give up sort of a belief that you have. And when it comes to our dogs, sometimes our own beliefs can really get in the way of that. Coda, what are you doing, buddy? Hey, buddy. Oh, I can't flip it. He's trying to sniff everything. I mean, he's being a dog, right? Come on, buddy. Anyways, you know, most people would want to drag the dog away a little bit when they are sniffing, but that's how they learn. To me, that's like them going on Facebook and getting their information, trying to see what you know, their friends are doing. Well, they can't go on Facebook, so they simply sniff. They sniff and they learn what, you know, what other dogs were there. They learn what's going on. That's just what they do. So back to what I was saying, you know, I'm going off in a different topic. But anyways, beliefs. They can be really destructive and they can be really beneficial. It really depends on whether you are sort of believing the right thing. And again, it can be very hard. No one wants to admit that they're wrong, and no one really wants to change something without having any type of proof. And I understand that. I'm the same way. I mean, I don't want to change what I'm doing or say that I'm doing something different if I think I'm right. Why should I expect you to do that? So for those who have worked with me, you know, I as a dog trainer, obviously, I think I'm right in what I'm doing. I think I'm doing the right thing. I'm trying to give you what I believe is the right information. If you do not accept that, you want to argue with me as I work with you, I understand. Again, I'm as a dog trainer, if I'm trying to tell you to do something different with your dog, I'm basically saying that you're wrong and I'm right. I truly believe I'm right, but I also can see it on the other end. You probably think what you're doing is right. You're just doing your best. And I get that. But those beliefs can be really destructive. And I like to give something of myself. I used to believe, this is a little crazy, but like back to Pearl Harbor, I was reading a bunch of stuff about it. I used to think it was like an inside job. It was this whole conspiracy. And well, of course, I was the one who was right. Everyone else is wrong. And it wasn't until I actually played this video game now with one of my friends. And it actually has to do with, like, you're controlling the whichever country you choose to be. And you're basically, it's a strategy game. You are, I forgot what country I picked. My friend, he's helping me learn this game, but it's based around World War II. And I got to learn a little bit about that. And I'm like, holy shit, I'm wrong. I learned some piece of information. I actually had no clue about what was going on with, like, Japan and China at the time. I never knew this information, and I thought, like, whoa, I was right. What I was reading in history, like, I got what was right. But no, I'm wrong. I feel kind of stupid, but it's I mean, I was given the wrong information, and I kept listening to it, and I believed it. And I mean, I believe that's just basically a conspiracy theory then, but I really fell for it. It's not because I was stupid, it's not because I'm not intelligent, simply I was given the wrong information, and I went too much on it. And we can sort of make those mistakes with our dogs as well. We can believe things that aren't true, we can have our own emotions tied up into it, and it can really affect the dog. It really can. Excuse me, it's really cold out here. It's making my nose all runny. It's hard to make this video. I had to check on Coda. He's just so damn cute. He is. But anyways, this video, I want to make this a little short. I don't want to keep going on. But basically, your beliefs can affect your dog. It can affect it in a positive way. It can affect it in a really dangerous way. And it's okay to admit that you're wrong. It's okay for me to admit that I'm wrong. I just admitted something that was, I mean, a conspiracy that I used to believe in. That's, no one wants to talk about that. No one wants to say that they're wrong, and I get it. So the point of this video is, understand, is something that you're doing with your dog affecting him in a negative way? It's a good question to ask yourself. Really question your own beliefs at times, because sometimes you can be wrong the same way I can be wrong. And if you have any issues with your dog, you know, he's not someone who's just sniffing around. He's always anxious. He's always looking around and he's worried about something. He probably could be fear. Get help. Whether it comes from me, whether it comes from a veterinarian, I believe that you should always see both a dog trainer and a veterinarian. But, you know, get the help for your dog. We are responsible for them. And they take care of us as well.